When you're working with Umbraco Forms, you have full control over what happens when a user submits a form. Do you want to send out an email to yourself or perhaps to the submitter? Or do you just want to redirect the user to a thank you page on your website? It's completely up to you. My name is Sophie, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can easily attach workflows to your forms. Let's get going. When viewing your form in the Forms Designer, you can find the workflows all the way at the bottom. As you can see here, there are already some default workflows that has been attached to our form. So on submit, the user will be sent to a page on our website and an email will be sent out to me, the creator of the website. So these two workflows will be added to any new form that you create. To change them, click configure workflows over here. The first workflow we already have is go to page. Here you can add a submit message that will be displayed on submit, and you can specify a page on your website where you want to send your user after they've submitted the form. If you do not specify a page, the message will simply be displayed on the page where the user submitted the form. The other workflow that's been predefined is sending an email to me. As you can see, there is a bunch of options to customize this workflow. You can also delete it and create another if you wish. All right, so now let's go ahead and try to create a new workflow for this form. We'll click Add Workflow. Umbraco Forms ships with 9 different workflows. Follow the link I've put in the description of the video to learn more about the different types of workflows. For this video, we'll set up a workflow that uses the data from the submitted form to create a content node on our project. It's the one called Save as Umbraco Content Node. All right, first up, we'll need to give the workflow a name. As we're going to use the data from the form submission to create content based on the person document type, we'll call it New Person. Using the active box here, lets you disable or enable the workflow without having to delete and recreate it again. So for this, we'll of course leave it as active. All right, next up, we have to choose which document type we want to use for the content we're creating. So from the dropdown here, we will choose person. This gave us a lot of new fields. What we're looking at here is all the properties from the person document type. Now we need to go through each of them and associate them with the fields on our form, or we can choose to give them a static value. For the purpose of this video, I've taken the liberty to update our form a little bit to match the person document type. All right, so let's start matching these. For the node name, we're going to choose the name field on our form. We're going to skip department, and for description, we're going to choose the message field. Email will be the email field. And I've added a few social profile fields on our form to associate with these. So for Facebook, we'll choose Facebook, Instagram, Instagram, and we'll skip the LinkedIn and photo. And for the last one, Twitter. There we go. Now that's almost it. Next, we need to decide whether to publish the content node right away. I'm going to leave this unchecked as I would like to approve the content before publishing it to my website. And finally, we need to choose where we want to save the content node. So if we go to choose here, it'll give us our content tree. And I can choose under which node I want to place the node. So I'm going to put it under people. There we go. And now our workflow is ready. So let's go ahead and click submit. And we can now see that our workflow is added to the dialog here. Click submit again. And we can see that it's also been added here below our form. Great. So if we go ahead and save our form now with the new workflow and head over to the front end and refresh the page. So let's see this workflow in action. We'll fill the form out here, put a name, work at Umbraco is going to be the message. And I would put in my email. And for the social media, as none of these fields are marked as mandatory, I'm just gonna pick my Twitter alias here. Great, so let's go ahead and click submit. All right, it displays a thank you message here where our form was before. All right, so let's head over to the back office and go to the content section. So now we should be able to find the new content under people. And there it is, an unpublished node with my name. So if we go ahead and take a look at it, we can see that the data from the submitted form has been used to fill out my name up here, my email down here. And if we go into the social tab, you can also see that my Twitter alias has been filled out. Sweet. Now that I've approved this content, I can go ahead and save and publish. And let's head back over to the front end and check it out. We need to go to the people section. And there it is. We've now attached a workflow to our form that creates a new content node whenever the form is submitted. As I mentioned earlier, there are a lot of different workflows you can attach to your form, and you can even build your own custom workflows. I've added a bunch of links to our documentation to the video description below. That was it for this video and also for this Umbraco Forms tutorial. Now that you know a little bit more about the product, I hope that you are ready to jump in and start adding awesome forms to your websites. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you around.